What's going on, guys? This is Ryan with RK Outpost, and it's hard to believe that a company can be as poorly run as Disney Lucasfilm, that they can drive a franchise into the absolute dirt, and everyone there still keeps their jobs. But day after day after day, they continue to prove just how inept they are, especially in the aftermath of the firing of Gina Carano over her political beliefs. This company has been facing severe backlash, both Disney and Lucasfilm, and it has not stopped, with seemingly every day bringing a new scandal or a new embarrassment for this company. And one that we talked about 2 weeks ago, they've literally just repeated the same exact mistake and are getting destroyed yet again. Now, if you remember, I covered this again like 2 weeks ago when they tweeted this. Star Wars official Twitter account tweets out this picture of Finn, John Boyega's Finn, with an accompanying quote next to it, talking about black representation, talking about how much they care about black representation in media, and everyone demolished them for good reason. Take a look at the quote. Storytelling is at the heart of being human, and black representation in all media gives us the opportunity to feel like we are part of the world we're living in. To be seen and heard more gives us a chance to feel like we are understood by those consuming our stories. Now, the reason that they were so mocked, so ridiculed, so laughed at over this entire thing is because of the clear hypocrisy. Not only did they diminish Finn's role, did they treat him like shit, is he a laughable character, but they even literally shrunk his character on the Chinese poster. On the Chinese Force Awakens poster, I think everybody's seen it by now, but let's just give a reminder for everyone. Here it is, in America, featured prominently right next to Rey. The only people bigger than Finn are Rey and Kylo Ren on this poster. However, for the China release, because they want that Chinese money, and they think that they can't do it if they feature a black man prominently, Finn gets shrunk down and hidden behind all of these other characters. What an absolute joke for Lucasfilm to then go and say, look at how much we care about black people and love black people. The irony is that 2 weeks later, they retweet this and share an entire article about it, about the same thing that they got all this backlash for. It's almost like this article is like explaining away the mistake that they made. Their way of saying, look guys, we know we've made some mistakes before, but we really care about this. Trust us this time. And of course, no one is believing them. We go back to that original post. Let me finish off the quote for you. Stories can show how a character can overcome struggles and conflict, and to see someone like yourself in that story is a springboard for the imagination. Introduce that to an eager mind of a child and you inspire the next generation of storytellers and beyond. Mel Milton, artist of this Finn illustration for Black History Month, hashtag Black History Always. Again, absolutely destroyed. Let's just go see some of the comments. What do they say? Then why the fuck did you shrink him on the poster? Pander much? Here's Steph. John Boyega, I'm the only cast member whose experience in Star Wars was based on their race. Heel versus babyface. You shrunk him in the poster to appease racists, you hypocrites. Lucas Filth SJW, that's pretty good. Here's Nerdrotic, truly abhorrent. We love Gina Carano, pointing out the clear hypocrisy of exactly what we stated, of the fact that they shrunk John Boyega in the poster. How dare you talk about storytelling as if you have any clue as to what that is? Data Racer, you clowns made John Boyega a janitor. Virtue signaling about representation after this racist stereotyping. And again, it seems like ever since Gina Carano has been fired, the magnifying glass has been on Disney and on Lucasfilm. And almost everything they post, fans come in there and destroy it. Talking about the hypocrisy, whether it be things like this and things with China, you know, when they thanked the Chinese Communist Party for allowing them to film Mulan right by the concentration camps. They don't say anything about that because, again, Disney, Lucasfilm, they want the money from China. So it doesn't matter who they have to pander to. It doesn't matter if they take the virtue signaling they did and try to hide it from everyone else. They want that Chinese money, and they will do anything they have to get it, including lie, deceive, cheat. It doesn't matter. They will say whatever they need to say to get your money. And the idea that they went ahead and did it again. They did it again after getting wrecked. They tweeted out this article. We will look at this article because I think Mel Milton actually says something interesting. They didn't put this in the original quote, did they? What the thing that I think that Mel Milton says is very interesting, they didn't put that here. We will get to it, but let's take a look at some of the responses. You racist Chinese sympathizers should take the hint and stop posting shite. We're not buying it anymore. The missed potential of Finn, there, fixed it. Lord Carnerjacks, just stop. Every single time you post one of these, you get destroyed by fans. Point out the pure hypocrisy of these statements by Lucasfilm's past behavior. Where was your happy birthday wishes for James Earl Jones or Carl Weathers as you gave one to Kelly Marie Tran and Laura Dern? We all understand why. It is always about the narrative and the message. And there are some people, it just depends. If you're part of the old guard, if you might be considered one of those people that might support Gina Carano, if you're part of the old original trilogy Star Wars, they have no interest in you. They will not talk about you. They will not promote you. All they care about is advancing their agenda. Again, the poster. Again, this guy. I just want to say, regardless of your thoughts on TLJ, at least Ryan gave Finn screen time and character development. JJ was the one who tossed Finn aside. This guy reminds him, you could literally remove Finn from TLJ and nothing in the movie's main plot would change. 100% true. You go to the quote tweets, same thing. A serious disconnect with their fandom. They celebrate Finn for Black History Month, but shrank him on the poster. Oh yeah, that's a painful title considering what your company did for the Chinese market money. Fire Kathleen Kennedy. It's like they're deaf. Star Wars talking about Finn as an inspirational Black character is a joke. They are getting destroyed. And it's ironic because when you look at this article from Mel Milton, the guy who drew this, he says something very similar. He says that he was disappointed in Finn, that he didn't like what Star Wars did with Finn. That's basically what he's saying here, to be quite honest with you. After two more films, Milton says he still doesn't feel Finn's journey was complete. Finn has shed his armor and his borrowed jacket to become his most authentic self as seen in Star Wars The Rise of Skywalker. Yet in this portrait, his eyes are focused in the distance, looking towards the horizon all that lies ahead. I myself enjoy this character, but there's also something that was missing for me, Milton admits. To be able to sit and say when we tell people stories, it's when we overcome something. There's a moment when the main character overcomes a conflict and it's like, that's why I want to be that character, because I have my own problems, I have my own things to overcome. And I think the potential of Finn was that. But you know what that statement doesn't talk about? That doesn't talk about race. And that's the problem. The quote that they shared earlier was very specifically about race and only how you can identify with the character because of the color of their skin when you see yourself in the skin color of the person on screen. That is laughable. That is idiotic. That is a problem in Hollywood and storytelling in general. The idea that you can only identify with someone if you have the same color skin, the same gender, the same sexuality. That is a joke. Because I agree with what he said initially before he gets into all his pandering virtue signal garbage. The fact is, when you see a character on screen and they overcome something, you identify with that character. If it is earned, it doesn't matter if that person's Black, white, Asian, Hispanic, it doesn't matter if they're a man or a woman, it doesn't matter what their sexual orientation is. That is the problem. That is one of these things that Disney Lucasfilm continues to not understand. That the people that they hire for them continue to not understand, because all they want to do is push their narrative and their identity politics. They only see you as something, right? They see you as your color, they see you as your gender, or they see you as your sexuality. That is a problem with all of entertainment, and Lucasfilm continues to step in it over and over again with these failed virtue signals that continue to backfire. It's almost unfathomable. Like I said at the beginning, it's hard to imagine these mistakes keep happening. They keep missing the point. They keep not understanding what their audience wants, who their audience is, and how to appeal to them. All they can do is go further down this path of identity politics. And it's sad because Lucasfilm was one of those companies that everyone wanted to work for and that everyone appreciated who worked there. Even if you didn't necessarily like the product coming out, everyone there cared about Star Wars. Now it's the opposite. The vast majority of people who seem to be in these positions of influence and power at Lucasfilm, they don't want to keep Star Wars for Star Wars fans. They want to change Star Wars from what it inherently was. And that will not be successful. That will continue to fail and will always fail as long as a lot of these people are still in power. Let me know what you think about this in the comments below. Smash a like button, subscribe to the channel, ring the bell for notifications, share this video out there, and I'll talk to you later. Thanks for watching, everyone. And a huge shout out to my patrons. I appreciate you guys so much. Want to follow me on Twitter or Instagram? Check out the description below. You'll find links to my PO box and my Patreon as well.
I'll talk to you guys later.